You're watching 10 News, and union troubles and construction delays have plagued Victoria's desalination plant, but builders now say they hope to begin pumping water late next year. 10 News has been given a rare tour of the site as the controversial project enters its final stages.
From the ocean, one third of Melbourne's drinking water will be created by the desal plant at Wonthaggi. Construction of the $3.6 billion project is just over 80% complete. The pumping station will push seawater through a chain of filters. A network of tanks begins the conversion process.
It's the logistics of putting this together, putting 300,000 bits of kit together.
It's the biggest desal plant outside Saudi Arabia. Every litre of seawater converts to half a litre of drinking water once the salt is removed. And in this network of pipes, 8,000 tubes will extract the salt.
This is really the game. Without this, we don't make the water.
The building, which houses the filter system, is an area as big as the MCG. 100,000 plants will cover the roof to blend in with the environment. Then there's also two massive storage tanks which can hold treated water. And these are the pumps that will send it on its way. The process time from salt to pure is about an hour, but it's so clean it's tasteless, so they have to add minerals.
This allows the water then to be identical to your normal drinking water.
It all comes down to this single pipe, which will pump water into Melbourne's supply. The state government says the desal plant will cost Victoria almost $2 million a day, every day, for the next 30 years. And that's regardless of whether the water is used.
T says delays have cost $280 million. Then there's union troubles and a spying scandal.
So it wasn't a very satisfactory approach on the part of ourselves, but... You know, that's behind us.
Underground pipes run 84 kilometres from the plant to Cardinia Dam. Mark O'Brien, 10 News.